please share with us the virtues of a sick person.
It is mentioned in the hadith, Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من يريد الله به خير يصب منه. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when Allah تبارك وتعالى intends goodness for anyone, Allah puts that person into adverse conditions. The goodness referred to in this hadith refers to the person being cleansed from guna and sins. Now, for us of people of Iman, who are conscious of our qabr, conscious of our journey towards akhirat, what could be a greater worry for us than the load of sins on our shoulders? Our biggest concern is that we must be offloaded of sins and guna. So when Allah puts adverse conditions on our lives, it becomes the means of our sins being forgiven. It is mentioned in one hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the hadith is narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, مَا مِن مُسْلِمٍ يُصِيبُهُ أَذَى مِن مَرَضٍ فَمَا سِوَى إِلَّا حَتَّى اللَّهُ لَوْ سَيِّئَاتِ كَمَا تَحُتُّ الشَّجَرَةُ وَرَقَهَا أو كَمَا قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Whenever a Muslim goes to any adverse condition, whether it's a sickness or anything besides a sickness, it could be wealth-related, children-related, whatever the case may be. But because the person went to adverse condition, that adverse condition and the difficulty that a person goes through, that Allah wipes out all his sins. And by way of example, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned, it is just like in winter when the leaves fall off the tree. How the tree is without any leaves, just like that, all the sins fall off from a sick person, completely pure and clean. It is also mentioned one hadith, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam went to one woman, Hazrat Sa'ib radiallahu ta'ala anha. So Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked her, Ma lak tuzafrafin, what's happening with you? Why are you shivering? Qalat al-humma, la barakallahu fiha. She mentioned, I got a fever. And after that, she mentioned, may there be no baraka in this fever that I'm experiencing. So see what Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told, La tusabbi al-humma. Fa'inna tudhib khataya ibn Adam, kama yudhib al-kair khubas al-hadid. Don't swear the fever. Many people that are going through this fever, this COVID-19, and whatever the case may be, contain yourself. Don't get angry. Don't get frustrated. Because if for us, no pain is in vain. No pain is in vain. Nabi Sasa mentioned, this fever, it wipes out the sins of a human being, like how a furnace, it removes the dirt, or like how that fire removes the dirt from the furnace. Likewise, in one hadith, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam reported to have mentioned, when Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala decreed a stage for a person in Jannah, and he cannot attain the stage to his amal because of his weakness in amal, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala put him into these challenges of life. Hatta tuballighuhu al-manzila allati sabaqat lahu min Allah. Until Allah makes him reach the stage which Allah has decreed for him in Jannah. And just one more hadith, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam reported to have mentioned, that you know, one person, if he goes through a sickness, and by the time he comes out from the sickness, so many people went through COVID-19, they went through challenges, breathing experiences, lung problem, whatever. By the time you come out from it, kayyumin waladatu ummu. It is just like the day your mother has given birth to you. Completely pure, clean, pure, like the day your mother has given birth to you. So this, we make dua that all those people that are infected with sickness, Allah grant them shifa, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant them sabr, and Allah ta'ala, they should condition their mind that no pain is in vain. I'm going through this, but I'm not going to come out without any reward. I'm going to become completely pure and cleansed from all sins.
Q&A with Mufti Ibrahim Desai, Wednesday, 6:30 to 8:30 p.m.